Well, looking at the outcome this morning on that unremitted funds, alleged unremitted funds, is Femi Awoyemi. He's a CEO, ProShare, and also an economist. Good morning, and thanks for joining us this morning. You must have seen all of this back and forth when this particular story broke, even though, well, they said it wasn't meant to be an open letter, but the letter, well, got to the public, and we've been talking about it. Tell us what your thoughts on this.
The first thing is that I think it's important that we put most of these things in proper context. The key issue at stake here is the Nigerian economy. Also at stake is also the integrity component of those who occupy offices. But the subcontext is that how do we treat matters which affect the core of the Nigerian economy if principals like the CBN and the president cannot exchange correspondence and it becomes open? What I believe happened in this particular case is that I believe sometime in January to June, according to the CBN, July 2013, CBN had gone through, I believe, let me get the right thing, the pre-shipment inspection documents, and found that about 600 million barrels of oil had been shipped out. And from his records, he would have expected a particular amount around $65.3 billion. But from what he got in his revenue was about $15 billion. So therefore, there was a difference. Normally, you would expect that when you have such discrepancies, there will be an exchange between the CBN and the NNPC. Well, we are not privy to that information if it did happen. But you would expect that such exchange would happen. That would be the first point of call. The second point, or perhaps a corollary to that, is that there's also an exchange with the Ministry of Finance. If this had been done and they did not get any answers, you would then expect that it is consistent, therefore, to expect the central bank to then escalate the matter. My own interpretation would be that it was therefore escalated by writing to the president. And now, was it the right thing to do? Yes. Procedurally, you raise it back to the commander-in-chief, the head of the cabinet, whom you all report to. That suggests to you that there was discussion in place. If there were no discussions, however, then you want to begin to ask, why did it go straight to the president without relating to the other arms of the agencies? Now, having gotten to them in September, this is where leadership issues also comes in between, because it's about Nigeria. You would expect that immediately that letter got there, there would have been a summoning of this, because that figure, let's put it in context, if the figure were true, you were talking about Nigeria's budget for 2 years aggregated together, the whole country. There were subcontents which people would ask, because if there was no money, where were we getting money to run the country? But then if it was just this portion of it that was the problem, then it becomes a top priority matter to be resolved. So September, October went, November left. And so for some reasons, since we entered, to use your word, the season of letter writing, the letter found its way into the public domain. That letter finding its way into the public domain should equally trigger certain things. One, the sense of national responsibility, knowing fully well that it has huge impact on the Nigeria's economy, financial standing and rating, especially to the global society. And so people should immediately come out and say, look, this letter was just a routine thing. We were working on it. I will get that. But since we're in a system whereby we trust each other less, we believe each other less, it then took a political undertone. But then guess what? The most important thing is that within 24 hours or 48 hours, when the president summoned the meeting with this revenue reconciliation meeting, we got it almost resolved. Now, my own take is this. The little difference of $10.8 billion, again, just raises another issue. How can we not, and I've always been consistently bothered about this, how can we as a country not be able to understand and appropriate correct figures for what we produce? Why should there be a problem with not getting it right? But then if you look at the context within and the NNPC issue, is that they are changing contracts, we move from joint ventures, we move into different agreements, there's so much happening that it then raises the focus that unless you take one or two issues, one, deal with those PIB-related matters, which still is hanging at the back door. But secondly, understand that we seem to have a fundamental problem whereby the Ministry of Finance, the CBN, the key revenue earners on the MDAs, they don't seem to be talking to each other, and somebody is not collating, because somebody should come out and say, I have the correct figures.
Because that's very important. I'm going through the some of the findings, summary of the findings of this revenue reconciliation meeting among the central bank, NNPC, DPR, Federal Inland Revenue Services, the Office of the Accountant General, Office of Budget of the Federation, Federal Ministries of Finance and Petroleum Resources. Well, it's a full house anyway. And you're talking about reconciliation of these figures, of what comes in and what goes out. Now, if we look at it critically, now we understood that something at least is still not accounted for, but it's not as huge as what we thought it was. But we're trying to look at how they operate, because the story we always hear is that, you don't know how we operate, you don't know how it works for the CBN. We've also discussed with some bankers and economists who would say, well, if ideally they check the books of every banker, definitely they would know when something is not remitted, maybe monthly, quarterly, or daily. Why wait for it to get to this huge amount before squeal or scream? So tell us how they operate from your own experience as an expert in that field.
It's a very, very disturbing development, and to say, to begin to talk, that we had to wait for about 19 months to raise a reconciliation. Like I said, you would expect that there are routine and monthly checks that happen. And this routine and monthly checks is a very simple thing. The CBN sees all the pre-shipment documents. He knows what was shipped out of the country. He knows the balance. He knows what he's expecting. I think the real argument you should be asking yourself is that if NFP says this money had gone to DPL and then money had gone to Federal Land Revenue Service, who is the banker to all these agencies?
Isn't it the CBN?
Exactly the point. Then again, who owns NNPC? The federal government of Nigeria. Who's the banker to the government? To the government, CBN, right? All these transactions should pass through the CBN. Now, the question I'm asking is: who are we operating a separate system? Because you call me an expert, and I say I can get more confused myself.
excuse me.
No, you should take me out of C, because
I get a bit more confused. Because if you say the money went to DPR,
then
if the money went to DPR, went to Federal Inland Revenue Service, went to NPDC, who are the bankers to those ones?
I think that, as you rightly pointed out, I mean, in terms of reconciliation, you have actually pointed out certain things that ought to have been done. And we ought to ask questions as to whether or not these things were done. We understand that the CBN put out a message in the Daily saying that they do not wish to join issues with the NNPC.
That particular communication is quite unhelpful. Quite unhelpful in the sense that, well, you do not discuss matters of government on pages of newspaper, but once it broke, once it became public, the game has changed. Then they break the whole purpose with about transparency. Then we step up that game, and then we continue on that same mode.
It shouldn't have happened in the public.
It shouldn't have happened, but it's in the public. But then you then need to deal with that substantial allegation that the whole budget for 2 years' worth of could not be found. But the key word was this. They said unremitted, unrepatriated. They may be technical terms. But then when you sensationalize or when you write, it becomes missing or not found.
Now, I mean, you were talking about those processes. I was actually trying to draw a line of thought from, you know, the processes that ought to have been, that ought to have taken place. And then, okay, maybe it didn't take place for whatever reason, And then it finally gets to the presidency, let's say sometime in September. And, you know, as you rightly pointed out, you would think that the parties involved would have been called. But what we got was that a query was issued to the NNPC, which they say they replied, and that they thought it was all was well and good with the world. You don't know if, you know, the CBN was intimated as to, you know, what the NNPC had said on that particular, in its own particular letter to the president. And so we have all this, it would seem, disconnect. And it's not until this came into public limelight. I mean, by this time in December, when this letter finally came out to the public, one would think that what you would get from the CBN is that, well, we did raise this letter sometime in September, but our fears have been allayed. I mean, one should have heard from the CBN saying that this matter has been laid to rest. There has been clarification and really no money is missing, or that, you know, whatever the money was, we know the whereabouts of the money and we will get it immediately. Instead, what we got from the CBN was them saying that they were not going to join issues. What does that do for us?
We can situate, I concede with your line of thought, but we can then reduce the whole conversation to a communications problem. But that's not the problem. We have a deeper problem. The deeper problem is that the CBN spotted certain things. If you look at it against the context in which this was being raised, you know, we were dealing with lifting of crude oil problems. We were dealing with the LNPC itself, the Minister of Finance, and everybody was talking about the fact that we have this oil theft and we had issues. So if you look at the subtext within which this was discussed, that can create in the minds of people this suspicion, or naturally you say they are put on inquiry immediately. And as such, they would then be worried that what's happening, we didn't see this money, we didn't understand it. But then there are two issues that come out here. If a central bank of Nigeria does not therefore understand the way and manner in which the NNPC is structuring its businesses enough to understand what it is expecting in the Federation account or how those monies get back to it, and that's a key issue Nigerians should be interested in knowing.
So how do we get that issue? Because this discrepancy in figures between the major revenue earners is not something that started today. It's been there for years and years, and we keep talking about it.
It's a discrepancy more in processes and understanding of how affairs are conducted. If the way NNPC conducts its business is different from how the CBN understands it, that is the key issue we should focus on rather than the drama behind it.